There's quite a bit of work involved in building a control cabinet like this. And knowledge. What fits together? What requirements must be met? Which technical parameters do planners have to consider? It would be great to have a sample solution for this. Maybe there already is one. Today, meet Andrew, who is going to show me a very cool feature of the planning software Clipx Engineer. Hi, Andrew.
Hey, Sasha.
You want to show me the functional engineering today. What is this?
Yeah, so functional engineering is a concept that helps our customers to work with our products without having a deep knowledge of how they should fit together at first. It also helps reduce engineering effort by providing application examples of the way different systems that these can fit together with.
So functional engineering is to speed up and simplify the engineering process. Mm-hmm. How does this work out?
Yeah, let me show you. So you can see here we have our tool Clipx Engineer, and functional engineering is an integral part of it. So it's really broken into two different parts. The first part is what we call our static macros. You can find them here in the backstage. So we have a couple of projects here, and I'll show you one of them. We have more details that you can learn why the specific design decisions were made for this different products. And then I'm able to open this project and use it for myself. So as you can see here, I now have this project in Clipx Engineer. And I am free to move things. I can take this and put it down there. Anything that you can normally do with Clipx Engineer. The next part is the configuration-based functional engineering. And you can find that here on the ribbon. Today, I will show you the 24-volt supply system configurator. And what this is essentially doing is asks you questions based on your application, and from those questions makes calculations about what the right products for your system is. So let's say in our system right now we have at the moment just one circuit loop that we're trying to power. So let's change that to 3. And now we gain the ability to configure some additional channels. And you can see that now we have a larger power supply, we have more circuit protection modules, and more terminal blocks. Now, let's say that I'm happy with this solution at the end, and I'm now ready to import it into my project. I can say finish configuration, and a solution ID is created that can be recalled at a later time to recall this configuration. My bill of materials is presented to me, and I'm now able to add it into my project in Clipx Engineer.
Very interesting, Andrew. Thank you very much.
No problem.
Now, that's what I call an intelligent solution. Unfortunately, this was already our last video on Clipx Engineer. If you want to learn more about the software or try it yourself, visit us at phoenixcontact.com/clipxengineer.